What's going on, everyone? Snake from Spiritfly here. Today I want to show you how I make the eyes on my streamers bulletproof. I use a couple of different glues for this. First being just some super glue. I like Gorilla Glue, that's what I stick with, but just some any old super glue will work. You want to build up a nice layer underneath the fly that really works into the material so that you can press your eyes together and make those eyes solid. What I use next is this clear Gorilla Glue, and this is for making a nice outside shell and help protect the eyes from teeth or whatever, you know, whatever may happen to the eyes, that they get pulled off or chipped or anything like that. But this is a very slow drying glue. It takes about 24 hours to fully set. The other thing I really like about this glue is it doesn't dry like rock hard, you know, like a rock. It's very solid, but it has some flex to it, which is why I know some people may ask, why don't you just use UV? Well, this stuff is a lot more expensive, but it is great. This UV resin by Loon, great stuff. I use it to finish the thread wraps on a lot of my other flies. But for this application, I'm using a lot more glue, and this Gorilla Glue for this big bottle, I don't know, maybe it's like 10 bucks, and this will last you forever. You'll be able to tie a lot of flies with that. So that's why I use that over the UV glue. So the fly I have in front of me right now is what I call the Mini Pike Pop. This fly has been really great for pike. I used it a few times this year for some big bass, so I'm really looking forward to the spring season for some big largemouth. I will definitely be throwing this fly for that. But more specifically, I designed this for pike and muskie because when they go after bait, they tend to T-bone the fly. With this is that's a 3-aught hook on there. It's dead center, right in the middle of the fly. You can see the eyes are here, tail's here. It's about 6 inches, so that hook's right in the middle. When a pike or a muskie is trailing this, what I designed this to do is turn to the side. Those flat eyes like that, glued and pressed along with the bucktail hair at the head, really allows it to turn on itself like this. So, you know, let's say a pike or a muskie is trailing behind this and you strip it and it turns and shows its profile on the side like that, that gives it a perfect ambush opportunity for them to attack it, and your hook is right there smack dab in the middle of the fly. So yeah, let's get into how I tie the fly. I'll show you more of the details of how I work with the glues and how I make these eyes really solid. Let's get into it.
Roll down my window pane. Tell me who you are. Notice we're not the same, but I need you in my arms, girl. Living out on the streets, working the boulevard. Tell me what you working for. Tell me what you working for. Let's go. I need you all alone. Thought this out and I know. So much more. I'm tired of chasing. I've been here before. Let's. Roll down my window pane. Tell me who you are. Notice we're not the same, but I need you in my arms, girl. Living out on the streets, working the boulevard. Tell me what you working for. Tell me what you working for. Let's go. I need you all alone. Thought this out and I know. Yeah, you're so much more. I'm tired of chasing. I've been here before. Let's go. Something out of nothing and watch it grow. Yeah. Oh.
I've been here before. And if I see you quiver, know that I'm not so inside. I've been known as a giver. You say, say me, don't you play me. And if I see you shiver, know that there's no use to cry. I've been known to deliver. You say, say me, don't you play me.
To this thing, make it really come to life. So what you want to do first is you want, wherever you're going to set your eye, just kind of turn your fly, make sure that spot is nice and clear. There's no loose hairs or anything like that. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take your super glue, you're going to pick your spot right where you're going to put your eye. Give it a nice little glob there. And once you have it sitting there, take your bodkin and just kind of work that glue into the fibers there. Just work it all the way down. Once you got that to where you like it, you're going to add another dot here. You want to be generous with it. Add that to the surface. Grab your eye. And to line it up, what I do is I'll put the edge of this eye right at the furthest point of my threads there. Right at the back of the threads. And then just close the lid on it. Use my bodkin to kind of just press it slowly, just work it in there. Just making sure that it's really glued to the core of the fly and not just the fibers. Really press it in there a few times to make sure it's nice and flat. That looks pretty good to me. Flip it over and do the other side. And when I turn it, I kind of look, if you look at it from the front of the fly, you want your other eye to be pretty horizontal with the ground. And just repeat the same thing. Make sure there's no loose fibers where you're gonna put the eye at. Make sure everything's out of the way. Put a nice little glob of glue there. Take your bodkin and work that in. Just kind of jabbing it to the core of the fly so that that glue has a nice base all the way down to the core so it gets past all those fibers. And then give it a second little coating here in the same exact spot. Grab your eye. Same thing, line it up with your thread wraps right at the back there. Line that up. Close the lid. And I'll use my bodkin to start pressing that into the fibers again. And then just kind of eye it, make sure it's lined up properly before you really start pressing it in. That should do that. Yeah, the other eye is good. That one really grabs. Sometimes it doesn't grab, you'll have to re-glue it again, which is fine. It still has the same effect. It's just that the first initial gluing, you want to really press those fibers, press them flat so that it gives that eye that space and creates the nice flat head. Turn this over to this eye. Now I'm going to take the Gorilla Glue, and you want to be pretty generous with this because you want this glue to kind of seep around the edges of the eye. You want it to dome up a little bit over the eye, creates a nice shiny gloss finish. And then you want it to kind of run over to your thread wraps too, so it creates like one solid unit there with the eye so they don't get pulled off or chipped away at. And then just kind of use your bodkin to distribute that glue around the edges, and then most importantly to your thread wraps there. Like I said, don't be afraid to be generous with it. You wanna really build it up, create that solid protective layer, and it looks nice when it's all dry. That looks pretty good to me. You can see there it's kind of created this dome over the eye and the thread wraps. And from my experience, the eyes would get ripped off. You know, if you're going for pike or muskie, maybe their tooth would catch the front of the eye there and kind of just pull it right off. So I focus on creating, you know, like a little head over the eyes that really protects it and your thread wraps as well. And then it goes all the way around to the back of the eye as well, so that it creates a almost like a mask, and that helps create that rudder effect with the head so that it really cuts through the water and darts side to side. So yeah, that's all there really is to it. It's a little bit more, it takes a little more patience to get that that clear finish like that. With the glue being slow drying, it's not as quick and easy, but it's pretty simple, not much to it, and you get that nice finish. You can see it's really clear. You don't see any yellow or anything like that. A little bit of the red got on the thread wraps there, but that's just from the red feathers. But that's it. That's how you create that rock solid face on your flies so that your eyes don't peel off and they're not chipping away. They'll last a lot longer, especially on fish like bass and trout. If you're putting these kind of eyes on your streamers, they will last for the life of the fly. And for pike and muskie, it's not guaranteed they'll last forever, but they definitely last a lot longer in my experience. Thank you guys for tuning in. Really appreciate you guys watching, and stay tuned for the next one.
Smallmouth.
Here we go.
go, baby.